client account number, unique client account number. It is 16 digits. So how do we identify a client in NSDL or CDSL system? Every client is given unique 16 digit number, and in CDSL and in NSDL there are different formats. We will see one by one. First of all, you should understand that the first 8 digits stand for the DPID, that is the depository participant ID, that is the ID given to the DMAT account provider with whom the client has opened a DMAT account. The next 8 digits stand for client ID, that is the ID given for that particular client. So these two put together is known as client account number, that is 16 digits. First 8 digit DPID, the next 8 digit client ID. So totally 16 digits. Now let us see what is the format in NSDL. In case of NSDL, all account numbers start with IN. Okay. See here we have given an example. The DPID starts with IN. So IN 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is 8 digit number. This represents DPID. The client ID can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So both together forms the client account number, that is IN 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So totally 16 digit. So remember, if the client account number starts with IN, it means that he is having DMAT account with NSDL. In case of CDSL, it straight away starts with a number. There is no IN here. That is the only difference. See here, in CDSL, DPID is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and client ID also like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So both put together forms the unique client account number in case of depository system. So totally it is 16 digits.